Raymond's incident is Hawaii's third shark bite in a month. Many have been wondering what can be done to address these recent attacks. Current procedures call for warning signs to be posted on beaches within a 1 mile radius from the location of an incident. But some have asked about shark culling, like in the past.
Over the decades, culling of sharks has not been found to be effective. The scientists who study shark movement and behavior have noted for some time now that sharks have a wide range and rarely stay in the same place for long.
Officials say culling is also detrimental to the ecosystem. In the meantime, officials say they're in need of more resources. Alex Serbol is digging deeper to find out what those are. Alex?
Aloha, Joe. I reached out to all the counties. Honolulu, Maui, and the Big Island all say they could use more rescue watercraft. With more manpower and rescue watercraft, crews can patrol the waters and respond even faster.
I learned there are 6 rescue watercraft on Oahu, 2 on the North Shore and 1 to patrol Makaha, Kailua, Town, and Sandy Beach. But Ocean Safety Acting Operations Chief Kevin Allen says they need more.
If we can have crafts that are actually stationed at beaches, we can cut the response time down dramatically.
On Thursday, the Department of Land and Natural Resources told me they are reviewing their internal shark procedures and plan to review those details with each county.
We want to make sure that everything's up to date and we have the right phone numbers, make sure we have enough signs for everyone, and that everyone knows what their role is.
So we check what the shark incident protocols are right now. I check with Hawaii County. The deputy fire chief tells me if there is a shark sighting, a chopper is sent up to survey the area. They have 4 watercraft, but the fire chief tells me they could always use more. On Maui, rescue watercraft are stationed at 7 lifeguarded beaches. There are 3 backups. Ocean Safety says they need more lifeguards and rescue watercraft. Kauai has 3. Honolulu Ocean Safety says it needs more lifeguards to operate rescue watercraft. We checked with Honolulu Mayor Kirk Caldwell to see when that could happen.
And we'll look at any requests made by our lifeguards for additional watercraft or other things that they need. And in addition to a watercraft, when you buy another one, you need another lifeguard to operate it. So we also have to grow our lifeguards. And that's important too.
I asked a spokesperson for DLNR when they will have their updated shark incident procedures, and I was told likely early next year. We'll keep you posted on what we learn. Alex Serbol, KHON 2 News.
With so many recent attacks, we spoke with an ocean expert who weighed in on what you should look out for while in the water.
The ocean has its own language, you know, water, current, all those kind of things, and even life in the ocean. So, you know, when we see fish jumping or running, there's 2 things. They're either chasing food or they are food.
Kealana also said you should never be alone in the ocean and do not enter the water if it's brown. There was another shark spotted off Oahu's North Shore today, prompting warning signs to go up. Around 9:45 this morning, 2 surfers told lifeguards that a 10-foot shark chased them into shore at the surf spot Leftovers. They were not hurt. Signs were posted at Leftovers and Chun's Beach and near Waimea Bay at a spot called Uppers. A shark was also spotted this afternoon again off Makaha. Warning signs are still posted there. We will continue to track these shark incidents and bring you the latest on air and online at khon2.com.